In this video, you will learn the procedure to create the 3D model of this object, and in the process, you will get accustomed with basic solid modeling operations and applications of UCS in BricsCAD. So let's get started. Let's change the view to top, front, left to match with the view of the model in the drawing. Click on top, front, left face in the look from widget. To start with, let's create this particular profile. You can see that this is a left face. So to align the UCS to the left face, click on the view tab, click on the flyout in the coordinates button, click on UCS to get the user coordinate system dialog, click on left to align the UCS with the left face. Next, let's create few construction lines to complete this profile. All the dimensions are taken from the figure. Click on line command, pick a point somewhere over here, keep the cursor straight down after keeping the ortho mode on. Type the value 60, then keep the cursor in the rightward direction, type 60. Now we have constructed these two lines. Next, give offset command and give an offset of 20. One more offset with the same distance of 20. Then another offset with the distance of 30. Then another offset with 5. One more offset with 15 as the offset distance. And the last offset with 10 units as the offset distance. Next, let's create the profile using the polyline command and connect all the necessary endpoints to complete the polyline profile. And click on close to close the polyline. So this is the profile which we have created. Next, take the cursor onto the profile and you will get the chord menu, and hover the cursor onto modeling and click on extrude. Keep the cursor in the negative Z axis direction and type the distance 60. Now the profile got extruded. We don't need these construction lines anymore. So select all the construction lines using a standard window and give erase command. Next, we will create this particular component. For that, we will create the profile and extrude. So using the polyline command, I'll start from this point. 5 units in the plus X direction. Come straight down. Shift right click and pick a perpendicular point. Then connect these endpoints and close the polyline. Next, select the polyline and we can extrude it using the extrude option in quad. Then give a height of extrusion of 13 units in the negative Z axis direction. Next, let's move this component in the negative Z axis direction to the desired location. So select the component, click on move in the quad and pick this point as a base point. Keep the cursor in the negative Z axis direction and type a distance of 37 units. Next, we have to introduce a flatness in this portion. For that, we will create a profile first using a polyline. Come straight down to this point and connect the endpoints and close the polyline and extrude it using the extrude option in the quad. And give a height of extrusion of 10 units. Now we have three components, and let's combine all the three components to a single unit using the union command. So select the components and choose union from the model tab in the quad. Change the visual style to shaded with edges, and you can see that these components are combined as a single unit. Next, we will create these two holes on top. For that, we have to first align the UCS on the top face. So make sure that the dynamic UCS is turned off. If the dynamic UCS is on, the UCS will get automatically aligned on this face. Now let's see a few options of the UCS command. So click on the view tab, coordinates, and you can choose 3-point option of UCS command. This option will let you define a new UCS by specifying 3 points. Now you are asked to specify the origin point, point on the positive x-axis and point on the positive y-axis. This is the new UCS. Next, give circle command, choose center radius option and define the center point using absolute coordinates 15, 15. The radius of the circle is 4 because the diameter is given as 8 in the figure. Next, let's extrude the circle straight down and give an extrusion height of 60 units. Copy the extruded circle in the positive x-axis direction through a distance of 30 units. Next, we have to create a slot in this area. For that, I'll align the UCS on this slant face. Click on View tab, Coordinates button, and click on UCS face. This option will let you align the UCS on a selected face. Give Enter to accept the orientation of this UCS. Next, draw a line from this midpoint in the upward direction through a distance of 18 units. The dimension is already given in the figure. We know that the slot width is 20 units. Move this line through a distance of 10 units, which is half of the slot width. Next, we will take the UCS back to the previous configuration. For that, click on the coordinates button, click on UCS previous option. One more time, I'll repeat the UCS previous option to take the UCS back to the previous configuration. Next, I'll create a polyline starting from this endpoint, straight down to a point corresponding to this corner. Then I'll track this endpoint. Then I'll come back to this point, click on close to close the polyline. Next, I'll extrude this profile through a height of 20 units. Next, we will subtract the extruded circles and the solid which we have used to create the slot from the main solid. Select the main solid, hover on the model tab. Now choose subtract and you can select these extruded circles as well as this particular solid and give enter. Change the visual style to shaded with edges. Now we have completed the 3D model.